this aviation hub for this country, want to tell other countries that irrespective of whoever is taking the lead, that it does not matter. That those who are developing aviation, who are developing the airspace gateway into their country, they don't have two beds. I challenge anybody, but by the time we finish our terminal building, which is of the highest intelligent, smart, international standard anywhere in the world, if it does not meet any standard of any terminal building, if not beating anyone you've ever seen anywhere in the world, I'll pull it down and build another one before I leave office. So be rest assured, where the contractor have just given me assurances that letters by end of next year, that carcass you're seeing, you're just seeing the concrete, but the facade and so many other things about that building have already been paid for. So we are ready to launch and to occupy that global space of aviation development in Nigeria and in West Africa, and will not relent.
The total area for this construction is over 10,000 square meters on the floor. We have the next floor, which is about 5,000 square meters, and we have the last floor, which is above 8,000 square meters. This building is designed to process about 1 million passengers every year. And inside here, we have about 4 escalators. We have about 7 lifts. Outside the lift, we have about 5 bridges. And the beauty of this is not that you are passing through staircase. You're going to pass through lifts. So if you add 7 lifts inside, you have 5 bridges, and we also have what we call a remote access. You know, where you have an aircraft like a CRJ-900 that will not be able to connect to the bridge, you have to pass through the remote access to be able to enter bus and get to the aircraft. Outside the normal passengers lounge, we have VIP lounge. I can process that to seat about 200, minimum of 200 passengers and all that stuff. And because of COVID-19, we had to review the few things that we had already made provisions for to comply with the new normal. So maybe if you come here the next 5 months, you'll start to see and appreciate this terminal. But it's going to be one of the best, if not the best in the country. Don't look at the size, but look at what we are going to deploy in terms of technology. We will complete this terminal 3 months to completion date in terms of contractual agreement.
We can say this airport is 45%, you know, advanced. Let's not say completed, advanced. But if you want to add the equipments that are on ground, which we are not counting, we can say that the airport is up to 60% advanced now, because a lot of machineries have arrived. You see them here because there's no space to keep them. These are escalators. Some of them are lift equipment, some of them are in the store, some of them are outside. So many equipments have arrived. Let me say up to 50% of the equipments have arrived. Why this airport is also called a smart airport is that all the equipment in this airport, from the air handling units, chiller units, transformers, panels, everything in this airport will be wired. So this airport is going to be like the human body. And there will be a room, what we call the BMS room, Building Maintenance Systems room, where there will be screens, and all the equipment in this airport will be wired to that room. So whatever happens anywhere can be seen on the screen. The temperatures can be seen, the humidities can be seen, the flow lines can be seen, you know, pressures in pipes can be seen. So many things can be seen in that room. So if a transformer shuts down, we will know. If one of the air handling units shuts down, we will know. If there is a pressure build up anywhere, I'm talking engineering now, we will know before we have an explosion.
The best, the smartest airport terminal building that you have in Africa is in Abuja Ibom State. It's in Abuja Ibom State. Let us grow from strength to strength. May we increase from fleet to fleet. May we dominate completely.